On a Sunday visit to the Morris Museum with his kids, Professor Tony Shepard made a completely unexpected discovery about one of the world's most famous operas.
I discovered two main melodies that are connected with Butterfly herself in the opera, and that they're Chinese, not Japanese, and that at least one of them has a very strong connection to the plot of the opera because it's pornographic. My wife and I were on leave from Williams College last year, and we were living in Princeton, and we promised the kids we would go back home every once in a while to Vermont. And on the way back, we wanted to stop somewhere because it's a 4.5-hour drive. And basically, the only place open was the Morris Museum. And we knew that it had this Guinness collection of automata and mechanical musical instruments. And so that's why we came on that particular day.
Murto D. Guinness, from the Guinness beer family, spent a lifetime collecting mechanical musical instruments and mechanical dolls. After he died in 2002, the Morris Museum received his entire collection.
I knew that this collection was here, and being a musicologist, I was interested in it, but I had no idea it would have anything to do with my research whatsoever. So we entered the collection, and in the first room, there are lots of little, really cool objects that make music from the 18th and 19th centuries. We went into the next room, and there's a bunch of brown boxes, basically. And so my kids, they ran off. I, quite by accident, saw this tune sheet with Chinese writing on it. Well, the Chinese writing immediately actually made me think of what I knew about Puccini and the opera Turandot, because we've known since 1920 that he had heard a quote-unquote Chinese music box and had used tunes from it. But what was really shocking is when I heard the tune from Madama Butterfly, and I didn't know what to make of that. It didn't make any sense. What was a tune from the Japanese set opera of Butterfly doing on a music box with these Chinese tunes that he used in Turandot? So we know when he was composing Madama Butterfly, he did want to use Japanese tunes. At some point, it was pretty clear he didn't have quite enough tunes to use. He does use Japanese tunes in the opera. And it just so happens the two main themes associated with Butterfly herself, he did not use a Japanese source. For 100 years, we've been looking for the Japanese source for these tunes. There is no Japanese source because they're actually Chinese and they came from a music box. If you take the music box apart and look inside, underneath the reed organ section, the bellows that are hidden otherwise, you find some strange writing on the bottom of the board. It looks like fake Chinese writing, some kind of fake Asian writing. And there's a picture of a woman very clearly drawn above this writing. And when I first saw this many months ago, I thought this can't have anything to do with the story, nothing to do with Puccini at all. But I've changed my mind because we know that Puccini liked to draw sketches and caricatures. And this summer I was looking at some of his manuscripts, some of his sketches of other works, and I started to notice that the markings on his score, the way he would draw quarter rests or accent marks or cross out a measure, suddenly it hit me that those markings in his scores look a lot like the markings in this fake Asian writing on the box. Mark right there. The way that he crosses out a measure to say that this measure, you know, ignore this.
As the months pass and the additional research goes on, is looking more and more and more as though this particular music box had the signature of Puccini all over it. And that is really exciting to me.
Shepard documented the music box's travels from Switzerland to Shanghai and then to a family in Rome, the Ficinis, who were friends of Puccini.
And so my current theory is that Puccini knew Alberto Ficini, went to his house around 1902 or so and said, you know, I'm writing this opera about Japan, can't find enough tunes to use, Japanese tunes. And Alberto said, well, you know, my brother just gave me this music box from China. And there's a letter Puccini wrote where he says, I now have enough material from the yellow race for my opera. I believe the yellow race actually refers to Asia more generally. And at that point, he had heard these tunes on the music box and felt satisfied that he had enough to use. The thing that was most exciting, not only for me, but for people who I was telling bits of the story to as I was discovering it, was just how connected everything was. How this one music box not only connects to probably the most beloved opera, or one of the most famous operas of all time, but it also connects back in history to earlier European encounters with China. One of these tunes became even more famous in China itself because Puccini used it in Turandot, and so it becomes the theme for China to the extent that it's used at the Beijing Olympics during the medal ceremonies to represent China. And you can trace that back to Puccini, and now we can trace this back even further to one particular Swiss watchmaker, Fritz Bove, who in 1845 went to China, collected these tunes, and got them onto music boxes that Puccini heard.
The Guinness Collection of Mechanical Musical Instruments and Automata is housed in a specially constructed wing of the Morris Museum in Morristown, New Jersey,